Mike. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so Chris, what is this? We've been playing with this during the break.
Yes, this is called Oobleck. So a lot of times at the museum, we like to show visitors what they can do at home, just simple experiments they can do at home. So this is an extremely simple little experiment that you can do at home, and it's good for ages 5 through 55.
Okay.
And all it is really just 55? A mixture of cornstarch and water, and I add a little green food coloring. There's actually a Dr. Seuss book called Bartholomew and the Oobleck, which is where science teachers have gotten this name for this material. And what's cool about this material is when you mix it together, it's basically just cornstarch and water.
Okay.
But when you get it in the right proportions, you create this material that's a solid. When you play with it quickly, you can actually pick it up and move
and
it around.
Turns into
but the
liquid,
moment you stop, it turns back into a liquid, and then it'll just goop right out of your hand.
Okay, that's crazy.
So the scientific term for this is a non-Newtonian fluid.
Yeah.
In other words, it acts like a liquid sometimes, it acts like a solid other time. So it is like a liquid, but watch what happens if I hit it quickly.
Oh.
It's solid.
It's solid.
It doesn't splash.
This is fascinating.
Right.
Like, it really is.
So if you play with it quickly and move around quickly and put it under pressure, it acts like a solid. Otherwise, if you move slowly, it acts just like a liquid and it'll just run like a liquid.
And so you were mixing it during the break, so does it kind of separate
it
for
does.
A while if you don't stir it?
Does. It does. Like I made this last night.
Yeah.
But it's really simple, and what's great about this is it doesn't require any particular measurement. It's about a 50-50 mixture of cornstarch and water. We add a little green food coloring because in the book, the Oobleck is green.
Yeah.
But
you can do any color you want.
Any color you wanted.
Okay.
Or if you really wanted to be safe, you could just leave it as no food color and white. And then you don't have to worry if it gets on the carpet or furniture.
Yeah.
You let it dry, you vacuum it up later, it's no big deal. No
okay,
problem at
so
all.
It does come out of the carpet, you're saying?
It will.
If
the best thing
accidents.
To do would be to let it dry into the next day.
Okay.
And then you're just back to cornstarch, and then you would just vacuum it up.
Because you would think this would be a really messy thing, but it just dries.
It can be, but it cleans up easily. And it's non-toxic, and it's easy to make, and it's good for any age, and it's just a fascinating material. I mean, you can play with it all day, just like.
Yeah, well, I was saying, like, me and my friends, you know, Friday night, hanging, playing with
Oobleck party. That's right. That's right. Exactly.
Okay, that is too funny. And Chris, Discovery Science Place just underwent a ton of new renovations. Tell us what's going on.
We did. We closed down every fall for usually 1 or 2 weeks, and we closed down this fall for a couple of weeks. And the two big renovations were our Southside Bank area and our Christus Trinity Mother Francis area. Both of those were completely remodeled. And so those are brand new, and we're excited to show those off.
Oh, cool. We have this video here, too. Okay.
Yeah, this is actually on our website. We actually have a 3D walkthrough of the museum. You can actually take a virtual tour of the museum if you just go to our website.
Okay.
And what's cool is we did this just a year ago, and things have already changed. So we're always adding things and changing things.
And you weren't closed for that long. I mean, it was about two weeks.
Yeah. And we usually do that in the fall, right when school starts. It's a slower time of the year for us. So we take that time to renovate and clean and repaint.
You guys have
what
is that, a big ship there? You guys have so much fun stuff going on. So what is new this fall, would you say, that's really exciting?
So one of the things we're really excited about as far as curriculum and programming is we're working with the local Girl Scouts. The Girl Scouts have about 20-some-odd new STEM-related badges that they can get. And so the Discovery Science Place is providing programming for that. So October 14th, October 28th, if there are any local Girl Scouts at the Brownie and Daisy level, and if they're interested in getting their STEM badges having to do with robots or engineering, they can contact the Discovery Science Place, and we're going to have those classes there at the museum.
What a great learning experience. You guys always make it so much fun.
That's
so if people want to come visit and see the new renovations or maybe get more information on this, how do they do that?
Absolutely. They can come to us. We are open 7 days a week except for Mondays. We're closed on Mondays, so the other 6 days a week we are open 10 o'clock in the morning till 5 in the afternoon. Sundays 1 till 5.
Okay, perfect. Chris, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome. Do you want me to leave this with you?
Yes, please. Okay, I'm still playing with it.
Okay.
Okay, coming up next, donating to those in need. Nacogdoches holds a bone marrow drive. And then also later, strengthening the relationships between police and citizens, how they're bridging that gap. That's all after the break.